Welcome to biochemistry lecture. Today's question, what we are going to discuss in the fat lipid unit is beta oxidation of fatty acid. This is very important question in the biochemistry exam point of view. So listen the lecture very carefully. Now let's go into the topic. Fats are important source of energy, as 1 gram of fat gives 9 kilocalories of energy, mainly as triglycerols or triglycerides in adipose cell. The fats are present. The fats are present in the form of triglycerols or triglycerides in adipose tissue. Fat constitutes around 84% of stored energy, whereas protein constitutes around 15%, and carbohydrate in the form of glucose or glycogen constitutes less than 1% of stored energy. The beta oxidation of fatty acids, it is the breakdown of fatty acid to acetyl-CoA. It is the process of breakdown of fatty acid to acetyl-CoA. It occurs in the mitochondria, and this process is strictly aerobic. After production of acetyl-CoA, it is fed directly into the Krebs cycle or citric acid cycle. The acetyl-CoA, which is produced from the beta oxidation of fatty acid, will enter inside Krebs cycle. So this is introduction about beta oxidation of fatty acids. It occurs mainly in the tissues including liver, kidney and heart. And fatty acid oxidation does not occur in the brain. There are several types of fatty acid oxidation. The first type is beta oxidation of fatty acid. Second one, alpha oxidation of fatty acid. The third one is gamma oxidation of fatty acid. But the major part of fatty acid oxidation comes from beta oxidation. Hence, it is very important. So this picture tells you how the triglycerol, or the fat which is stored in the adipose tissue, converted into fatty acid. The mechanism is called lipolysis, and these fatty acids undergoes beta oxidation to form acetyl-CoA, which enters the citric acid cycle. Similarly, this acetyl-CoA can undergo lipogenesis to be converted into fatty acid, the reversal process, and this fatty acid can undergo esterification and it can be converted into triglycerols. So this diagram keep in mind so that basics you can understand very clearly. Now let's move on to the beta oxidation of fatty acid stages. There are three stages involved in the beta oxidation of fatty acids. First one is activation of fatty acids in the cytosol in the cell. The second stage, transport of activated fatty acids into the mitochondrial matrix with the help of carnitine shuttle. The third one is beta oxidation proper in the mitochondrial matrix. So the beta oxidation occurs properly in the third stage, that is inside mitochondrial matrix. So this is about beta oxidation of fatty acid stages. In stage 1, activation of fatty acid in the cytosol. Second stage, transport of activated fatty acid into the mitochondria. And third stage, the proper beta oxidation of fatty acid, which occurs inside mitochondrial matrix. Now let's see the stage 1. So stage 1 is activation of fatty acid. So this proceeds by fatty acid thiokinase, otherwise it is called acetyl-CoA synthetase. The enzyme which is activating fatty acid is known as fatty acid thiokinase or acetyl-CoA synthetase. This is present in the cytosol. Thiokinase recurs ATP molecule as well as CoA, sulfhydryl group and magnesium. The product which we get at the end of this reaction is fatty acyl CoA and water. So in the first stage, the fatty acid is activated with the help of the enzyme thiokinase, or otherwise it is called as acyl-CoA synthetase in the cytosol, which recovers the ATP molecule and CoA SH and magnesium. And the product which we are getting is fatty acyl-CoA. Fatty acyl-CoA we are getting here. Now, what will happen next? So in the second stage, the transport of fatty acyl-CoA, which is produced in the stage 1, will leave the cytosol into the mitochondria. So long chain acyl-CoA traverses the inner mitochondrial membrane with a special transport mechanism called coronitin shuttle. When you travel to abroad, you cannot travel in domestic airways like that. This long chain acyl-CoA cannot enter inside mitochondria. It needs a special transport system called coronitin shuttle. So this is representing the cytoplasm, and this part representing the mitochondrial matrix. This is the mitochondrial membrane. So inside cytosol, the fatty acyl-CoA, which is long chain, that with the help of the acetyl transferase 1 and with the help of coronitin shuttle, enters inside the mitochondrial membrane to reach the mitochondrial matrix. And this coronitin, once it drops the fatty acyl-CoA, that will go out for the replacing the entering coronitin. So this is happening with the help of acetyl transferase. Now let's see this in detail. So acyl groups from acyl-CoA is transferred to carnitine to form acyl-carnitine, which is catalyzed by carnitine acetyl transferase 1 in the outer mitochondrial membrane. So outside mitochondria, the acyl group from acyl-CoA is transferred to carnitine to form acyl-carnitine, which is catalyzed by carnitine acyl transferase 1 in the outer mitochondrial membrane. This acyl-carnitine is then shuttled across the inner mitochondrial membrane by a translocase enzyme. You can see here, this is the translocase enzyme. So here, the fatty acyl-CoA joins with carnitine to form fatty acyl-carnitine, and this shuttle towards the inner mitochondrial membrane with the help of translocase enzyme. So here again you see that the enzyme needed for this reaction to take place, acetyl transferase 1. So now you can see the third step, the acyl-CoA, which is transferred back to, that will be the acyl group is transferred again into CoA in the matrix by carnitine acyl transferase. So here what is happening, this acyl-CoA again it is converted into CoA with the help of acyl transferase 2 in the matrix. The acyl group is transferred back to CoA in matrix by carnitine acyl transferase 2. Finally, this carnitine is returned to the cytosolic slide by translocase in exchange of an incoming acyl-carnitine. So this is happening in the stage 2, that is the entry of acyl-CoA inside the mitochondrial membrane. Once it entered, it is converted back to its original form CoA in the matrix with the help of the enzyme carnitine transferase 2. This carnitine will go back to the cytoplasm for exchanging of the incoming carnitine. Now let's see this in diagram here. So this represents the place where this is happening, the cytosol, and here the entry with the help of the carnitine shuttle inside the mitochondria. This is the mitochondrial matrix. This is the membrane, mitochondrial double layer membrane, outer mitochondrial membrane, inner mitochondrial membrane. This is the transporter, that is, which allows the carnitine shuttle to travel here. So this leaves the CoA. The CoA is separated here, and this carnitine, with the help of acetyl CoA transferase, it goes back. So this diagram you can draw in the exam. Now let's see the third step. The third step is the proper beta oxidation in the mitochondrial matrix. The third stage occurs in four steps. That is the proper beta oxidation of mitochondrial matrix, which is happening inside the mitochondrial matrix, takes place in four steps. Step 1, oxidation of FAD linked dehydrogenase. Step 2, hydration by hydratase. Step 3, oxidation by NAD linked dehydrogenase. Step 4, thiolytic cleavage thiolase. So this is four steps which involves the proper oxidation of mitochondria. So this is the one type of fatty acid. This is one type of fatty acid, long chain fatty acid, which contains 16 carbon atoms. So you know, this is the alpha. When you give nomenclature for the fatty acid, alpha system. So we are starting the this is a COOH terminal. So the carbon molecule which is next to the COOH will be the alpha one, and next will be all beta, then gamma, like that it will be going. So mainly the reaction takes place in the first two carbon molecule near to the alpha, near to the methyl terminal. So that is why it is highlighted here. Now let's see what is happening from the first reaction of the third stage. So here the oxidation of acyl CoA by an acyl CoA dehydrogenase. So first thing happening here is oxidation of acyl CoA by an enzyme called acyl CoA dehydrogenase. So that gives alpha beta unsaturated acyl CoA, also called as enol CoA. Here FAD is the hydrogen receptor. So FAD receives two hydrogen molecule. So the diagram says that, so this is the place where the beta oxidation takes place. That's why it's a beta carbon molecule in the fatty acid. So what is happening here? Oxidation takes place with the help of the enzyme acyl CoA dehydrogenase. The acyl CoA is converted into enol CoA. This is converted into enol CoA. So during this process, what is happening? The FAD molecule receives hydrogen receptor. FA molecule receives hydrogen receptor. As a result of that, the structural changes takes place in the beta carbon. So there is formation of one double bond, and two, the hydrogen molecule, one from the alpha, beta, gamma, the gamma carbon atom, and one hydrogen from the beta carbon atom is received by the FAD molecule with the help of the enzyme acetyl CoA dehydrogenase. This acyl CoA is converted into enol CoA. So this is the first reaction. Now come to the second reaction. The second reaction is the hydration. This is the enol CoA, which is produced in the end of the first stage. So enol CoA undergoes hydration. So that is addition of water. So addition of water to the double bond of the beta hydroxyl CoA. So the beta carbon, where we have seen, so the double bond is broken by the addition of water. So that forms, this is what changes takes place in the one OH molecule is added. One OH molecule is added in the gamma carbon, and one hydrogen molecule, because of the addition of water, one hydrogen molecule is added to the beta carbon. That is, it becomes CH2. So for this reaction to take place, we need a enzyme enol CoA hydratase. So addition of water to the enol CoA, that is, as a result of that, the beta carbon receives one hydrogen molecule and OH molecule is added to the gamma carbon atom. Enoyl coate hydratase is the enzyme helping in this reaction. Now let's see the third reaction. This is the oxidation of beta hydroxyl hydroxyacyl CoA. The beta hydroxyacyl CoA, you can see this beta hydroxyacyl CoA, which is produced at the end of the second stage. The second stage, the end product beta hydroxyacyl CoA will be converted into beta ketoacyl CoA, will be converted into beta ketoacyl CoA. For this reaction, it needs NAD molecule. It needs NAD molecule. The enzyme which is responsible for this conversion is beta hydroxyacyl CoA dehydrogenase. Beta hydroxyacyl CoA dehydrogenase. So what is happening here? As a result of this oxidation process, the changes takes place in the beta and carbon atom here. So one OH molecule, that is one hydrogen molecule, that is to this NAD, two hydrogen molecules, the NAD is receiving two hydrogen molecules. That's why it is converted into NADH and one hydrogen molecule is separated. So NAD receives one, it is in the reduced form, that receives one hydrogen molecule. So we have two hydrogen molecule which is present in the gamma carbon. So that goes to the NAD. One hydrogen add with the NAD to become NADH and another hydrogen molecule is in reduced form. So this has happened in the third stage. As a result of this, we get a product beta ketoacyl CoA. We get a product beta ketoacyl CoA. Now, the fourth reaction, the beta ketoacyl CoA, the beta ketoacyl CoA will be converted into acetyl CoA. For this reaction, there is a cleavage of the two carbon fragment. There is a cleavage, separation of the two carbon fragment by splitting the double bond. So this double bond will be split between alpha and beta carbon. So this is the alpha carbon and this is the beta carbon. So between this, the cleavage in the double bond takes place. So this occurs with the help of the enzyme acetyl transferase, acyl CoA acetyl transferase, otherwise it is called thiolase enzyme. It is called thiolase enzyme. So the beta ketoacyl CoA undergoes cleavage of two carbon fragment by splitting the double bond. So this is happening, this is split with the double bond which is present in the alpha and beta carbon. So you can see that, so because of the split of double bond, so one, there is change, there is change in the structure. So it becomes acyl CoA, otherwise it is called myristoyl CoA, myristoyl CoA and acetyl CoA. This acetyl CoA, which is produced by the cleavage of the two carbon fragment in the double bond region between alpha and beta carbon, this acetyl CoA will enter inside citric acid cycle. So this is fourth reaction. So fourth reaction, the beta ketoacyl is converted into two substances. One is myristoyl CoA and acetyl CoA. This acetyl CoA is very important, which enters the citric acid cycle. Now, the overall reaction is mentioned here. So you can see this, you can draw in the exam, which gives you more mark when you have drawing the process of beta oxidation correctly. Now the finally, the release of acetyl CoA leaves an acyl CoA molecule shortened by two carbons. So this acetyl CoA production will leave an acyl CoA molecule which have two carbon atom short. This acyl-CoA molecule is the substrate for the next round of oxidation, starting with acyl-CoA dehydrogen. So this acyl-CoA again goes to the first step with the help of the enzyme acyl-CoA dehydrogenase. So this acyl-CoA, so this substance acyl-CoA will again go into the first step. The meristyl-CoA, otherwise called as acyl-CoA, will go to the first stage again. Repetition continues until all the carbon of the original fatty acyl CoA are converted into acetyl. The big long chain fatty acid will be converted into acetyl CoA. Till that time, this beta oxidation will be repeating again and again. So we have seen that 16 molecule carbon, till all the carbon molecules split, this reaction will happen again and again. In the last round, 4 carbon acyl CoA, that is butyl CoA, is cleaved to form 2 acetyl CoA. So here the 2 acetyl CoA molecules are produced in the last round. So what are the energetics of beta oxidation? The first one is beta oxidation of palmitic acid, the fatty acid which we have taken example in this beta oxidation, palmitic acid. So beta oxidation of palmitic acid will be repeated 7 cycle, producing 8 molecules of acetyl CoA. So the palmitic acid, when undergoes beta oxidation, it has 7 cycles. It produces 8 molecules of acetyl CoA. In each cycle, FADH2 and NADH++ is produced and will be transported to the respiratory chain. So one FADH2 molecule gives 2 ATP molecule, and one NADH++ gives 3 ATP molecule. So 7 cycle which produce 35 ATP molecules. So energetics of fatty acid beta oxidation is also important question. So 7 cycle gives 35 ATP molecules. Each acetyl CoA which is oxidized in the citric acid cycle gives 12 ATP molecules. This we already know, that we have studied in the citric acid cycle. Each acetyl CoA which is oxidized in the citric acid cycle gives 12 ATP molecules. So 8 into 12, we get 96 molecule. So because this cycle repeats 8 times, so we are going to get 96 ATP molecule. 2 ATP molecules are utilized in the activation of fatty acid. It occurs only one time, and energy gain is equal to, so what is the energy gain? Energy gain is the energy produced minus energy utilized. That is 35 ATP molecule produced. The 35 ATP molecule which we are getting from the palmitic acid cycle, 35 ATP molecule, and 96 ATP molecule from the citric acid cycle when this beta oxidation of palmitic acid occur. So 35 plus 96 minus 2 ATP molecule. So because 2 ATP molecule is utilized for the production of fatty acid in the first stage, so we get totally 129 ATP molecule through this beta oxidation of palmitic acid. So this is about energy kinetics of beta oxidation of fatty acid. Hope you understood about beta oxidation of fatty acid. This is very, very important question. So focus on the steps in beta oxidation of fatty acid with diagram, and also learn the energetics of fatty acid. So, I hope you all understood this. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you again with De Novo Synthesis. Take care. Bye-bye.